Hello, I will talk about the comparative analysis of supervised machine learning algorithm for heart disease detection. This paper describes the most prominent algorithms of supervised machine learning, their characteristics and comparatives in the way of treating data. So, the heart disease data set obtained from Kaggle was used to determine the test of its highest percentage of accuracy. So, to achieve the objective, we use Python sklearn libraries to implement and select algorithms, evaluate and determine which algorithm is the one that obtains the best results applying decision tree algorithms achieved to the prediction results. So, machine learning is one of the fastest growing areas of computer science with a long range application. This refers to the automatic detection of significant patterns in data with machine learning tools. So it gives programs the ability to learn and adapt. Machine learning has become one of the pillars of information. With that reasonable central thought generally hidden part of our life. With the increasing amount of data available, there is a good reason to believe that intelligent data analysis will be even more widespread as a necessary ingredient for technological progress. So there are several applications for machine learning, being one of the most important data mining. The handling of large amounts of data makes people more likely to make mistakes during analysis or possible when trying to establish relations between multiple characteristics. This paper is focused in the classification of this algorithm. Identify the most efficient algorithm with the best precision applied to a set of heart disease data to determine the best results. What are the concepts? The concepts that we use here are the supervised machine learning are the linear classifiers. Linear models for classification separate input vectors into classes using linear decision limits. So the objective of linear classifiers in machine learning is to group elements that have similar characteristics values into groups. A linear classifier achieves this objective by making a classification decision based on the value of a linear combination of the characteristics. A linear classifier is often used in situations where classification speed is a problem since it is classified as the fastest classifier. So the another concept important is the Navy Bayesian networks that are elementary and are composed by acyclic graphs directed with a single parent. So, and several children with a strong assumption of independence between those children in the context of their father. So, the dependence model naive bias is based on the estimate. Bias classifiers tend to be less accurate than other more sophisticated learning algorithms. Another one is support vector machine. The support vector machine is the most recent supervised machine learning technique that support these machine models and are closely related to the classical multilayer perceptron neural networks. It has been shown that maximizing the margin and therefore creating the most significant possible distance between the separation hyperplane and the instance of each side thereof reduce an upper limit on the expected generalization error. Another one is the K-means grouping. The K-means grouping is one of the simplest sums and supervised learning algorithms that solve the no clustering problem. The procedure follows a simple and straightforward way to classify a given set of data through the a certain number of groups. As said a priori, the K-means algorithm is used when target data is not available. General method of conversion approximates general rules into a highly accuracy prediction rule. And another one is the well-known decision tree. Decision tree are trees that classify instances by ordering them according to the characteristics values. And another most used actually is the neural networks. They can perform several regressions and classification tasks at the same time, although commonly each network performs only one. What are the characteristics of the machine learning? Supervised machine learning techniques are applicable in numerous domains. In general, support vector machines and neural networks tend to work much better when it comes to multidimensional and continuous features, applies machine learning techniques for classification and prediction in five models in which their performance are compared. So the models are based on support vector machine, the random forest, the key nearest neighbor, and the naive bias, and softmax show that support vector machines algorithms work best with the large data sets and also for small data sets. Which one is the methodology that we use? The methodology to determine the best supervised algorithm applier in the hard disease data set will begin with the interpretation of the data, the processing of the data, and the application of the algorithm to determine the best accuracy. So we, in methodology, we use the data sets. The data sets used for this research will be the hard disease, which has found in the Kaggle repository, this database that contains 76 attributes. But all published experiments refer to the use of a subset of 14 of them. In particular, the Cleveland database is the only one that machine learning researchers have used to date. So the whole field refers to the presence of heart disease in a patient. The creators of this one are the Ungarian Institute of Cardiology in Budapest, University Hospital Zurich, and University Hospital Basel in Switzerland, and the Medical Center of the Long Beach and Robert De Trano. Okay. So, how we do the interpretation of the data? The data is extracted as is interpreted from an empirical chosen database. And so we consider the arterial pressure, the resting blood pressure, the serum cholesterol, okay, and also the fasting blood sugar. So, and the application algorithms, after understanding the data and interpreting the information to be generated, The following algorithms will be applied. The k nearest neighbors, because the KNN algorithm classifier predicts the class of given test observation by identifying the observations that are closest to it. So the scale of the variable is essential. Any variable that has a larger scale will have a much more significant effect on the distance between the observations than the variables that are on a small scale and therefore on the KNN classifier. So after determining the training and the test with the prep processing, let's use the elbow method to choose the good value. So later we apply the decision tree, and the neural network and the random forest and the support vector machine. So in each one, the data is processed, and in decision tree, there are a single decision that the tree will be give us using the scalearn library to evaluate the created decision tree. And so in neural network, the scalearn library will be used to pre-process the data to prepare for training. So in random forest, the data is pre-processed and the training and test variables are separated to train the model. The data is pre-processed to apply the algorithm. The training and test variables are separated. We train the model using the scale library. So, as a result, after applying the selected supervised learning algorithm to the data set chosen for comparisons, the following algorithm results obtained the k nearest neighbor KNN evaluating the model data used. So we also evaluate the decision tree. The decision tree with obtain the precision of this algorithm. And also the results we compare with the result with the random forest, with the precision 0.84 according to the data pre-processed and trained. And so in neural networks, also we have the results using the neural networks that are about the model that we use. So after evaluate all the algorithm we have compared, we conclude that the model of key nearest neighbor has obtained better results in precision with an average accuracy of 0.91 for the heart disease data set. So for future work, other types of classification or segmentation can be applied to achieve a better predictions of the chosen data sets. So this is an important work that will help to others researchers to choose the best alternative with the data that they manage. So this paper has been possible to carry out as a research due to the need of to obtain or generate knowledge from different professionals. So the authors wish to thank university mentors and their support and guidance. So thank you very much.